I have to admit that the last evolution with a robotic stapler with a SureForm has changed and simplified and increased the safety of the procedure. I think I had no major complication for 2 or 3 years thanks to this instrument.
The robotic stapler now gives us that autonomy to really control what is essentially the most critical step of the lobectomy. These small, frail blood vessels that come off the pulmonary artery, they're very thin.
The SureForm is very precise and the quality of the stapler line is perfect. So when you arrive around your ilum or around your vessel, you don't move. It's so precise. There is no stapling device at the same level. There is no comparison.
One of the most impressive things about Intuitive is it's not just a robotics platform. Robotics is just the starting point. And then we can layer in additional technologies. And where you see an example of that is with stapling. But now we have advanced technology. We have things like vessel sealer extend and SynchroSeal and SureForm.
Hello, my name is Jean-Marc Baste. I am a thoracic surgeon. I am professor of thoracic surgery here in Rouen University Hospital, and I'm specialized in robotic surgery. We have performed 1,300 cases in Rouen in 10 years. We have started with 25 cases per year, and now we are around 200 cases per year. I've seen a webinar in June 2012 from New York, Dr. Mark Dolesky, and I was impressed by the technique, the precision, and I was then convinced that the robotic platform will offer a better surgery to my patient, and I put the energy I need to improve my program.
My name is Daniel Oh. I'm a thoracic and foregut surgeon. I am vice president and associate medical officer at Intuitive. I'm also an associate professor of surgery at the University of Southern California in Los Angeles. I run the lung cancer program at Providence St. Jude Medical Center as well.
So I met Dan Oh in Canada 3 years ago because I was there to present the French robotic program.
Professor Baste is a very well-known figure in robotic thoracic surgery. I've been watching his career and what he's done in Europe with a great deal of interest over the years, and it's been phenomenal.
So during the training, there is 3 parts. The first part will be the lung resection with the different techniques. The second part will be about mediastinum surgery and with mainly thymectomy and esophagus surgery. And the third part will be on non-technical skills, image-assisted and new technology.
I think surgery starts before the operating room. It's meeting with the patient and understanding their situation, understanding what their medical condition is, how physically fit they are, what kind of family support do they have. All these things play into our decision making on how we're going to treat the patient. And then there's the medical part, which is, you know, what's the disease that we're dealing with? If it's a lung cancer, you know, where is it located? How big is it? What is the stage?
The results for the patient is better. This robotic platform completely changed my way of thinking the surgery. So for me now, it's a collaborative platform for my clinical practice, but also it's a collaborative platform for training.
I'm very appreciative of Professor Baste's technique, the way he's standardized this, and he's given it a name, you know, the French lobectomy. One of the challenges in lobectomy is that we have 5 different lobes, 3 on the right, 2 on the left, and they each have slightly different anatomy, different angles, and so you could potentially set up the case 5 different ways, depending on the lobe.
The French lobectomy is a standardized approach with 5 zones of dissection, and after you will choose how you will cut the different elements of the ilum. Standardization is very important for 3 reasons. The first is to improve your clinical practice. The second reason is to better train your fellow. And the third reason is to improve your evaluation with objective variables. The robotic system, it's a universal system now, you can find everywhere. So when someone finds a new way of doing, and which is better, you can mimic very easily. It's very easy to standardize when you use less instruments than when you have more instruments.
Anyone who sits in the console with Da Vinci, it's a magical experience that you have to translate into a rational and scientific way. That precision, that 3D view, the immersive experience, the scaling, tremor filtration, all the tools that we have at our disposal, you know, and to get to orchestrate that during the case. And then of course at the end, when we're done and the patient can leave the hospital, you know, it's truly a remarkable experience.
The future is very bright. So in fact, the robotic platform it's a huge collaborative platform, and it will impact everything, the clinical practice, the training practice, the safety. I can say that this platform is done to better treatment, better training, and better evaluation.